What is up, guys? Karma Medic here, and welcome back to another dose. If you're new to the channel, hi, my name is Nasir, and I'm now a fourth year medical student studying at King's College London, and I am addicted to saving time. Let me explain. Like a lot of you watching right now, I feel like there aren't enough hours in the day, and every single night before I go to sleep, there's still so many things left on my to-do list that I just simply didn't have enough time to do. So over the years, I've become obsessed with using my time as efficiently as possible in order to maximize the number of things that I can do in a day. That's how I'm able to be a full-time medical student while also running this YouTube channel with over 500,000 subscribers, cook almost all of my meals, exercise regularly 2 to 3 times a week, have a pretty great social life hanging out with my friends 2 to 3 times a week, and also have a girlfriend. Now, as much as it probably sounded like I said all of those things in order to flex or show off or whatever, I'm honestly not trying to do that. I just think that if I'm able to do all of those things with my time, then I think you can and anybody else can as well. I'm not a genius or special in any type of way. I've just become really good at managing and prioritizing my time, and that's what I want to explain in this video. One of the most important things that I do throughout the day is I'm very purposeful with my time. I'm very conscious about how I choose to spend my time on different activities. If you make a conscious decision about how you're going to spend your time, then even if you're doing something that's considered objectively less productive, for example, scrolling through your phone on Instagram, if I tell myself I'm going to spend 5 minutes scrolling through my phone on Instagram, then I feel absolutely no guilt about doing something that is less productive. I know that I'm going to gain some sort of social or entertainment value from the next 5 minutes of my time by scrolling through Instagram or whatever. Whereas if I just sat down on my bed and started scrolling through Instagram for an undetermined amount of time, and I just sort of kept on scrolling and scrolling, then that feels like a waste of time to me. Every action that I decide I'm going to do in my day, I have a vague idea about how long that action is going to take me. If I'm going to the bathroom, then I know that that's going to take like 2 or 3 minutes. If I'm cooking lunch, I know that's going to take an hour. If I'm going to watch a lecture, I know that's going to take between 30 and 45 minutes. And that way, if an activity is exceeding the time that I told myself it was going to take me, then I know I need to be wrapping this activity up and moving on to one of the other things on my to-do list or moving on in my schedule for the day. This way, I don't waste any time by doing a mindless activity, and I never get that feeling where the whole day has passed me by and I don't know what I've done with my time. I don't know what happened. I know exactly where my time went, and I purposefully and consciously decided what I wanted to do with my time. The most common thing that I hear from people when I'm having conversations with them about productivity or how to use their time, etc., is they always say to me, "I don't have time," or "there isn't enough time in my day to do that," or something along those lines. Now, if you're working 2 part-time jobs, or you have kids and a family to take care of, or your commute time is something like 3 hours each way, I understand some people actually don't have time. But I do think there's a large proportion of people who say that they don't have the time to do things when they actually do. They're just not prioritizing their time well enough. And what I always say to people when they tell me that they don't have enough time is that if there's something in your life that you really want to do, something that's very important for you, whether that's going to the gym, hanging out with your friends, playing video games, cooking healthy meals, whatever it is, make that thing a non-negotiable part of your life. So for example, right now I exercise every other day, and I alternate between going for a 10K run and going to the gym. And this activity happens every other day, no matter what. Even though it's 10 p.m., I've promised myself that every other day I'm gonna do exercise no matter what. So I'm gonna go upstairs, put on my running shoes, and go for a 10K run. No matter how late I come home from the hospital, no matter how tired I am, no matter what the weather is outside, no matter how many other things I have on my to-do list, every other day I will exercise. And so no matter what is going on in my life outside of that, I literally don't care. If it means that other tasks get delayed or pushed aside or I fall behind schedule, then that's okay. Exercise is something that's very important to me and something I've told myself is going to be a non-negotiable in my life. So it has to get done no matter what. Something that I find really helps me maximize the amount of things I can do in my day is I honestly almost never procrastinate. And I put the word almost in there because I don't want to make such a generalized statement. I have obviously procrastinated in the past and I will continue to procrastinate in the future, but I genuinely think I procrastinate something like 1 to 5% of all my tasks in my day or in my life. If I ever think of a task that I need to do or something just comes up in the middle of the day, I will try and do it right then and there. If I receive an email, I'll try and reply to it on the spot. If a friend messages me, I'll try to reply to them right then and there. At the end of every single day, I clean my desk so that it's neat and organized. After every single meal, I do the dishes or fill the dishwasher. Every time I come home and I hang up my clothes behind the door, I will put them in the closet shortly after. Doing these small things frequently really adds up and makes it so that you don't ever end up with clutter or procrastinate a bunch of small tasks that you need to do, and then your to-do list gets very full with all of these smaller tasks. I just do things as they arise, as they come up, and try and keep things as neat and organized continuously, as opposed to just letting it all pile up and then doing it at the end of the week. Obviously, things come up that you can't do on the spot, And instead of just pushing it to later and procrastinating it and saying that I'll do it later, I'll write it in my to-do list with a very specific time and action plan for when I'm going to do this and how I'm going to do this. That way, I don't just procrastinate the idea and get it out of my head for me to deal with later. I have a very specific action plan of how and when it's going to get done. There are a few things that I do in my life without having thought about it or planned it out first. Now, I'm not saying you need to take out a pen and piece of paper every single time you want to make a decision. I'm just saying that before I do most things throughout my day, I've at least thought about it and tried to digest what I'm going to be doing. When I'm thinking about what I need to do in a day, I will always think about how long those activities are going to take, how I'm going to move from one place to the next, etc., etc. So for example, if I want to travel to campus in order to attend a bunch of lectures, I'll always say travel time 9 to 10 a.m. Listening to lectures 10 to 10:30. Walking to the cafeteria 10:30 to 10:40. Sitting down for lunch 10:40 to 11, etc., etc., etc. And because I've thought about what my day is going to look like over the next couple of hours or over the course of the whole day, I almost never fall behind schedule and I'm very punctual to meetings, to class, or whatever it is that I need to do. Now I'm actually gonna head into lecture, which started about 3 minutes ago. And this brings me on to my next point, which is to always, always, always overestimate how long you think an activity is going to take. Genuinely, this one is so important and it's something that I see people fail to do all the time and it really impacts someone's plans for the day and I feel like it's a big reason why people fall behind schedule so often. After many years of obsessing with my time and how I use it, I've become very, very good at estimating how long tasks are going to take me to do. And the reason that I'm good at that now is because I have spent a lot of time timing myself doing different tasks and figuring out generally how long things take me. And then once I've decided how long that task is going to take, I always add on an extra 5, 10, 15 minutes or whatever, depending on what the task is, just to give myself a safety net in case things run over. There's absolutely nothing worse than telling yourself, okay, I'm gonna take a 1 hour lunch break and then start working again at 3 p.m. And then before you know it, it's like 3:15, you're still finishing off your lunch. And now all of the things you had planned for the remainder of your day are getting pushed back behind. Instead, if you think lunch is gonna take an hour, plan for an hour and 15, an hour and 20. And then if you finish early, well then that's great because now you have an extra 15 to 20 minutes in your day, which you can use to be productive and do other things that are on your to-do list. And if lunch actually ends up taking longer than you expected, well then you haven't fallen behind on your schedule and you're still on track for all the things you need to do in your day. Because I slightly overestimate how long all of my tasks are gonna take, I rarely find myself falling behind schedule or having to push things back. Instead, I find myself having these pockets of extra time that I've created for myself because I finished on time or ahead of schedule, if that makes sense. Now, the next thing that I wanna talk about is making use of dead time. Okay, the best way to explain this is organizing your time in such a way that you can make the most use out of idle or dead time. A very good and simple example of this is making a cup of tea. When you go to make a cup of tea, you always fill up the kettle and turn it on first. That's always the first thing you do because while the kettle is boiling, you can get your mug out of the closet, you can get your spoon out of the drawer, you can open up your tea bag and throw it in the mug, all while the kettle is boiling. You would never walk into the kitchen, first get your mug, then your spoon, then your tea bag, then go fill the kettle and boil it with water because then you're just gonna sit around for a bunch of time while watching that kettle boil. So this is a very simple example that I extrapolate to all activities of my life every single day. I figure out the rate limiting step of my activities or activities that have a lot of dead or wasted time in them, and I plan all my other activities around that thing. For example, if I have a script to write for a YouTube video or a clinical exam for medical school that I want to review and go over, I could do those two things while sitting down at my desk here late at night, or I could do those things while I'm on the train commuting to the hospital. And instead, I can use that time where I'm sitting at my desk in order to do activities that I can't do when I'm sitting down on the train going to the hospital. For example, using the internet to do some research or something like that. So reorganizing my time to make sure that I'm doing tasks during this dead or idle time when I normally would be unable to do anything else is something that helps me squeeze in extra hours or minutes of productivity throughout my day. All right, for this next one, I need a pen and a paper to explain. So this is what I call the path of least resistance, and hopefully you guys don't think I'm crazy after I explain this on camera. So basically, I always move around my physical environment in such a way that I minimize the amount of distance traveled, and I save little amounts of time or little amounts of distance in every activity that I do. So let's say I'm sitting at my desk over here doing some work and I want to get a refill on my coffee and also go to the bathroom before coming back and continuing work. So my house is set up in the following way. I have my desk over here, got the bathroom in the middle, and then I have the kitchen. Now how I feel that most people would carry out this task is in the following way. They would take their coffee cup and go from the desk to the kitchen, fill up the coffee cup, go back to their desk, drop off the mug, then go to the bathroom, and go back to their desk. If we did it like this, let's say this is 1 meter of distance, and this is 1 meter of distance, just for simplicity. If we did it like this, we would cover 2 meters, 4 meters, 5 and 6 meters of distance. This is not the most efficient way to do this. Another way someone might do this is go from their desk to the bathroom, use the bathroom, go back to the desk to pick up the coffee mug, go to the kitchen with a coffee mug, and then go back to their desk with their filled up coffee. Now again, if you were gonna do it like this, you would cover 6 meters of distance. Now how I would personally do this, because I obsess over saving time and minimizing the amount of distance traveled between doing different activities, is in the following way. I would take my cup of coffee from the desk with me to the bathroom, use the bathroom, then continue on to the kitchen, fill up my cup of coffee with my refill, and then go back to my desk and sit down to study. If you do it like this, then you only cover 4 meters of distance in order to complete the same set of actions. Now this is obviously a very small and specific example, and you guys probably think I'm crazy because I'm trying to save 2 meters of distance walked, or whatever time it takes for me to walk that extra 2 meters of distance. But if you take this one simple activity and extrapolate it to the tens of activities you do in a day, the hundreds in a week, and the thousands in the months and years, you honestly end up saving a bunch of time. I think a good example that might show how much time is actually saved over longer periods of time is the following. For example, when I'm on the tube and I'm going to catch a train, if I can hear the train running and I sprint in order to catch that train and I end up missing it, it doesn't actually matter that I missed that train. What actually matters is that 9 times out of 10, I would end up on that train and I would catch that earlier train. The fact that I missed that train once is completely irrelevant. It doesn't matter at all. And you're probably wondering and you want to ask me, Nasir, what are you going to do with all of those seconds that you save up over these long periods of time? And my answer to that is that it's not about saving an extra minute in your day so that you can watch an extra minute of your YouTube video or whatever. It's about this overall mentality of trying to maximize the amount of things in my day, trying to be as efficient as possible with my time so that I can choose to spend my time doing the things that make me happiest or doing the things that add as much value as they can to my life. And this is something that I'm continuously thinking about throughout my day, how I can maximize and be as efficient as possible in the motions that I'm doing. I know I'm like particularly obsessed with saving time and this is totally not necessary. That's part of what I think allows me to do all of the different things that I do in my life and stay on top of my schedules and my deadlines and things like that, is because I try and create this time whenever I can. I try and add as much time as I can in my day through cutting down these corners and improving my efficiency in moving around, completing tasks or whatever. The last thing that I want to talk about in this video is sleep. Now, I think most people consider sleep or sleeping in your bed or whatever, something that's very enjoyable, something that allows them to relax, something that allows them to relieve stress, etc., etc., which is completely fine. Personally, I don't see sleep like that at all. I see sleep as something necessary that I have to do, which takes me away from all the tasks and things that I want to accomplish in my day. And so when I wake up in the morning, when my alarm rings, I never check my phone when I'm in bed. And I never tell myself, okay, I'm gonna sleep in, I'm gonna get some extra rest or whatever. I've obviously slept in when I've missed my alarm or slept through my alarm or whatever, but I can honestly say I've never woken up and said to myself, okay, I'm gonna sleep for an extra 15 minutes, 30 minutes or an hour or whatever. As soon as my alarm rings and I wake up, I start thinking about the things that I want to do throughout my day and I just jump out of bed. This is both during the week and the weekend, and it's also during school time and on holiday. I personally sleep the minimum number of hours that I need in order to be a functional and normal human, not just like a sleepy zombie walking around throughout the day. And for me, I found that this is somewhere between 6.5 to 7 hours of sleep. That way, I don't spend any more time sleeping than I actually need to, and I can use that extra time of not sleeping doing things that I want to do in my day. Now, I'm not encouraging anyone to sleep for 6.5 to 7 hours. That's just personally what works for me. I'm saying that if you find out what your minimum number of hours of sleep is, whether that's 7.5, 8 hours, 8.5 hours, whatever, you can use the extra time that you otherwise would have spent sleeping in order to get things done throughout your day. Now, obviously, some people really enjoy their sleep. It's something that brings them a lot of happiness and adds positive value to their life. And I'm not saying that they should sleep any less or anything like that. I'm just saying what personally works for me for my own sleeping habits. One last thing that I want to say is that I'm obviously not a perfect person, and sometimes life just happens and I can't keep up and do everything that I've talked about in this video. What I think is important for me is that this is the mindset that I have, and this is the mindset and goals and things that I'm trying to achieve. And if I can achieve those something like 80% of the time, then I'm doing a great job for myself. So even though life happens and I might not be able to follow all of these things to a T every single hour of every single day, I'm trying to achieve this level of efficiency or productivity in my life, and I'm trying to work towards that as much as I can. Okay, and that's pretty much everything that I wanted to say about how I try and maximize the amount of things that I do throughout my day, how I try and use my time in as efficient of a way as possible. If you guys have any ways that you like to improve your efficiency or increase your productivity throughout the day, please do let me know in a comment down below. It's something that I'm constantly thinking about and constantly trying to improve on. If you enjoyed this video, please do leave a like on it and subscribe to my channel to see more content from me in the future. And that is it for me. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace. Now, a fourth year medical student studying at King's College Lucton.